It's been one of those days, people. Sometimes cake. Sometimes there must be cake. And yes, I am going to eat it while I stream. Because cake. Okay. So. Had a little bit of an interesting day, but I am ready to stream. And as you guys can see here, I worked up a little bit of a flowchart so that hopefully the logic of what I'm doing makes a little bit more sense. Also, doing this kind of process helped me figure out what we were doing wrong last time. In fact, it was something actually really simple. This here, clearing the value, the desperation attack, was down here. So I was running the equipment check and then clearing the variable, which meant that I was erasing everything we did. So that was obviously a problem. But anyway, we'll get started on that in a minute. How's everyone doing tonight? How is everybody doing tonight? How many people got on? I have recently discovered that you can actually see how many people are watching. Only 4 so far? That's all right. That's not too bad. I've started with fewer. Hi, MO6. Hi, Lock Kirby. Or should I say Lock Birdie? MO6U3. Where did that name come from? I am curious. I must know. Fill me in. While we wait for, like, both other people to show up. Okay, let's look at some stuff. Oh! So clearly, sitting on a hacking stream is the correct choice for your life. Doesn't happen to be an exam on Final Fantasy VI hacking, does it? What now? Moog? Oh, I see. That's supposed to say something. Am I supposed to know what that is, though? Well, there's a lot of space in chat. Feel free to tell me the whole thing. While you do that, I'll start pulling up some stuff. All right, let's load up Desperation, set up our breakpoint, which was back in here somewhere. Okay, good. Good luck. Then some R&R is the next thing you need once you've got enough study in. So this qualifies, right? This is healthy. At least that's what we're going with. Yeah, that right there. That right there. But where are we actually calling this from? 15CA? Or I think this should be CC then. Let's see. C215CC. Execute. Run. Pretty sure we had a save state in there. No? No? All right, well. That's what we were using. Did I happen to save after I had... Oh, right, that was a thing. That was a thing. I haven't done anything yet, so... Yeah, I still don't know why that does that. Even though it... stopped. Didn't it stop one of the times that we did it? I don't know. I don't know. I'll go and I'll fix some stuff too. Ah, hacking. Alright. Still, I'm gonna see if I can get the code to run. Choo-choo. There we go. All right. So as you can see, let's show the hex, show our RAM, and let's go look at our, is it 2F3F? Or is it the other way around? Might be 3F2F. Hold on. That looks more right. Should start at a zero value. Yeah, so the first thing we did was we ran this, and I'm going to step over it, so it'll run the code. Oh, she's not equipping anything, apparently. But you can see, after we run our check code here, then we have the store zero. So it basically would undo everything that we did. Hypothetically, if we had had this, and it was set to, we'll just say, oops, nope. And it was set to 03. Oh, by the way, you can edit the RAM in real time. As soon as it runs that command, it clears it out again. So that was one of our problems. It's called Moog from the Moog music devices. So Moog is a phonetic representation of that name. Ah, I see. So it's like a long, shortened Moogle. I'll take it. Dot, dot, dot. Wow, a lot of reasons. That's okay. That's good. I like that there's... Because when I see, like, weird letters and numbers strung together, I like, okay, this is just some random handle that someone used for a game because the one that they wanted wasn't available. But if it's got, like, actual backstory to it, then I'm like, all right, cool. Your name passes. It passes the test. Alright. So anyway, you see that clears in there. Because this guy right here comes after our subroutine. So going back to the flowchart, we need it up on top. We need clearing the variable to be the first thing that happens, not the second thing. Just an oversight. Alright. So, this here, and put stars around it so I would see it when I came back in. I'm just going to cut that out of there and put it up there. And what that's going to look like in the hex, just switching some stuff around. Open Desperation Plus, go to 217cc. Right. Yes, because it was jumped to long, and then that was the address. Hey, sup, Mad? No problem. It's only a few minutes late. I won't kick you out. Yet. Ooh, fancy. All right. So I'm gonna copy that, and then that 9C2F3F is gonna go there. And the set carry, which actually doesn't matter, I have found out. Well, it does, but I don't necessarily need it. I could actually flip a bunch of them, but it's really minor. And then I'll paste the jump back in. And that fixes that. And then real quick, let's go in and see what... Now, I don't have enough viewers yet to start kicking people out. Maybe once I reach 10, then I will obviously be way too popular for people to show up late, because, oh my goodness. Also, Mad, you missed, like, a quarter of my piece of cake. That's okay. You can enjoy the rest of it with me. Okay. Get rid of that. Okay. Alright, so next thing I'm going to do, I'm going to make sure that the weapons make sure the weapon I was editing has the correct thing set. I wonder if this here has something to do with the crazy glitch we're getting. I wonder if I should change this to a different bit. Maybe it's all bad. I don't know. But Illumina. Illumina headed. Who's got Illumina? Actually, I need to kill that and relaunch it if I want my change to take place. Priorities, man. Priorities. Oh, how's the game volume, by the way? It looks like I may have changed it at some point, my desktop. And I can't hear it at all because I've got it muted for me. But, who, me? No, I just have terrible allergies. And they've been pretty good, actually, the last couple years. But it's been hitting a little bit harder. Been hitting a little bit harder this year. Which is a huge pain. In the behind. Alright. See, that time it didn't do it. It seems to be totally random when it does it. When it does it versus when it doesn't do it. Alright, Illumina should have an extra chance. So I'll actually make sure I have that breakpoint set. C215CC. Yeah. And show hex RAM 7E 3F2F. Set range. It was perfect. Game volume, that is. Oh, I see. You're saying I'm not perfect. Just. Actually, you're probably right. Alright, you do the thing. There we go. Alright, store zero, hey, we got that one right. Alright, so step into, let's make sure that it's doing its thing. Should be pulling Illumina, it's checking the bit. Branch of equal, doesn't, it's rolling, so it's doing what it's supposed to do. Set carry, so we should have a one in there now, we do. I didn't have another one set, so we're gonna, we'll step out. Oh, good. She also had the relics equipped. That's right. So she's got two bits in there. And then, just checking the character and stuff. Let's just do a bunch of step overs. Till I get past all the stuff. Okay, I'm way past it now. Now, so that three, okay, and it's still three, so that didn't get cleared. So that means it's still doing its thing. So I can see that she had still just had the basic 1 in 16 chance. So I might do a little bit of playtesting with this. Get some kind of Okay. Well, I'm sitting here getting whacked. Alright, I'm like get rid of that breakpoint. Duh! Oh, bye, Cyan. Alright, so I seem to have fixed the logic there. The next thing I should probably check to make sure it's working properly is... should have a 1 in 16 chance of all those. Oh. Give me more stuff. I should give the monsters, like... 65,000 HP. It did. Good point. No, but we did get the 3, so we're getting the right values in our variable. I would really like to see a desperation attack happen when I'm not in critical health. Make sure that that's running properly. Also, I didn't even re-add the critical health thing. Terra should be getting 3 checks. Which should make it not totally uncommon. It's 3 checks at... I don't even remember what percentage we did. I do not even remember. That's okay. Come on. No, stop running away! Further. I guess it's still working, because it's not supposed to happen super often. I'm going to go ahead and make sure that the... Alright, so where is the part where it's doing this? According to HXD, I should be seeing... Which part here? Which part? This here. I put that at the beginning? Okay. I know! That's what I get for downloading a save off the internet. I'm such a cheater. This never would have happened if I was playing legit. Alright, this should be down close to the bottom here. I'm looking for OADA, so starting right here. So this is at C215F1. C215F1. And play. Well, this is better than sitting on the calculator for, like, 20 minutes like I did last time. Run the code. Why didn't you show me the code? What did I do? It did not stop me. C215F1. C215F1. OA, which should have been this right here. Is that getting skipped? I can't hack... Well, actually, I could if I went to the value in the hex, but then I would have to change it every battle, and I'm too lazy for that. I would rather just fast-forward and run again every time. Really? That's pretty cool. I wonder if one of these is a thing. Oh, wait a second, the random number. This is running up here. I'm sorry, I was looking in the totally wrong place. No wonder. This is where it's checking, up here. Why didn't you people catch that for me? And that, incidentally, comes literally right after the JSL. For the equipment check. Where am I going? Here. Alright, this breakpoint sucks. Let's do that. And that. Hiya! Alright. So step over, here, this one's the one we're going to step over. And we should be at 3, we are. Step out. I want to be here. 15D7. So it's checking for OF. Oh, actually, I think I actually hit it this time. Nope. Hold on. There's supposed to be another check in here. It's failing the first one. It's failing the first one and leaving. It should not be getting out. 1610 tells me that it's done looking for the desperation. See, I messed something else up. I knew what the logic was supposed to be, but when I was putting it together, I didn't do it right. Yeah, see, when it fails, it should not be jumping out to 1610. It should be checking for the next one. What I should be showing is that branch, what it should be doing is branching if equal. If it's successful, it should be jumping down to here and continuing the code. Right. Wait a second, why do I have two things in here? That's stupid. Branch if not equal, then branch if equal? Are you kidding me? Why did you people let me do this? Cake. All right. Please stop me from embarrassing myself, people. This is just as much your fault as mine. All right. So this just needs to disappear because reasons. This just needs to disappear. Because all I need is the branch if equal. EA success is where I wanted it to go, which would jump it down here. And then it goes back in, checks if the carry is clear, and if it's clear, that means it's done, doesn't have any more chances. So yes. Alright, I was just making sure that this is what I thought it should be. So let me knock that out. Alright, so we're back up here, the C, and then C220, and 290F. And then this here shouldn't be a thing. Go away. That's going to help. Yeah. There we go. Did I save that? Load game. Desperation plus. I'd better cancel this out before I accidentally do something with it and try to save and ruin everything I did in Hex. Yeah, and there's a check mark for reducing latency in the Twitch options, but it might cause more buffering for other people. Where did that wooden thing come from? Who was it that said they had a wooden computer or something? Like, what even is that? Okay, I have a wooden CPU. Why not? It's not impossible, it could happen. Alright. Yes, this data. It was a really tough choice. That's why I sat there for a while. And let me put my breakpoint back in. Ding. Skip up here. And let's make sure that this is running the appropriate number of times. Alright, store 0, set carry, skip the JSL, we know that's going to 3. Then it does, oops, step out. Alright. Checks it and OF. And that is much too large. Skip that stuff. Branch if equal. Yeah. So it's going to do that. So what we're about to check here after we, just so you can see what this command is doing right here. This is, rotate right. And we're doing it on 7E3F2F. So that's this variable here that we kept moving bits into. And we're going to look at the registers, and you're going to see, and what we're going to try to see is if that carry flag stays there, and it should, because 3 has a 1 in the last, in the bit 0. So when we rotate everything to the right, I think this should be right to you guys, it should bump that 1 over there. So hypothetically, if I got rid of this carry, so I'm going to get rid of that carry, but then I'm going to go ahead and take the next step. And we should see that carry flag pop back up. So let's watch that. Oh, I can't do that here. Okay, now I can do it. So step into. So it does that. And look, you see this pop down to 1. And edit registers. And there's our carry flag. Okay. So if the carry is clear, and it looks like I did that jump wrong. Good thing the carry isn't clear. That needs to be 2E. So you can see what address it's supposed to, clear out, you know, end up at. So did that wrong. It's supposed to be a 2. And this, 1E should be 2E. Let me keep going, just in case we actually get it. And then it's running again. Checks again. No, actually that failed. So I wonder what's going to happen. What's it going to happen when it jumps to 6-0? It's going to jump to here. It's going to jump to FA. F-A. Is that in the middle of a command, or is that an actual command? I'm actually really curious. Is that in my stuff? That's still in my stuff? F-A. It's going to pull X. Yeah, that's going to mess stuff up. It's going to mess stuff up, because we didn't push X, because that's up here. So what that's going to do is that's going to screw up the direct page. Or the stack, excuse me. That's going to screw with the stack. So this will be fun. And then it's going to store A and B6. So whatever's on the stack, it's going to store as the attack. Oh, this could be fun. This could be a fun glitch. Can I see in here what's on the stack? I kind of want to see what's going on. 15DF. I'm not sure whether it's going to be DF or 1.5 that gets loaded, but this is going to be interesting. Yeah, I will do the assembler thing with the next topic, but since we've already done so far in this, and this is what I know how to do, because that means essentially next time I'm going to be teaching on something that I'm just learning. All right, let's see what attack we do. Whoa! That got really loud for me all of a sudden. Oh. And apparently it's frozen. And she's frozen. That's right. Gonna do the same thing with everyone else. Unless I get lucky. Oh, there we go. Finally broke it. finally broke it. But we know why. We know why because we have that. Because we have a because we have a debugger. Woohoo! Breaking the game. It'd be a lot more frustrating if I didn't know why. But I already do. So, load game, desperation, run, breakpoint still set. Run! Yes, exactly. Screwed up my RTS. Do it! Do it! I wanna see... Alright, let's go at least go through and see and make sure that works the way we think it should. Okay, good. That's not doing that thing. Oh! Oh! Oh, it passed! It passed. Somehow. It passed. It went ahead and moved into the desperation. And that was empty. And then didn't do anything. Hey, we have new problems! We have new problems. At least that's correct. At least that's correct. And we have 81 up here now? How is that even a thing? Man, what did I do? What did I do to this game? This is a jumbled mess. Yeah, do not pass go. Do not collect $200, Tara. Okay. Step over. What am I looking at here? I don't even remember. Okay. Nope, that's not. Well then. Cake. This is really helping tonight. You have no idea. New problems. New problems. Okay, let's think about this. Let's think about this. Maybe I am not understanding the AND operator. Or maybe I messed up the table. Maybe I am messing up the table. Let's see. Each one is a 1 in 16 chance. Because AND is keeping anything that has the same bit. So that means anything that is something 0 will end up 0, 0. Which would set the equal flag, the zero, you know, the zero flag, because that's what branch of equal checks. Branch of equal or not equal checks this zero flag. Okay, right? So I don't think I have that logic wrong. So let's look at this. She wasn't near fatal. Actually, do I still have it in here? I kind of want to go back. Do I still have this in here? When did the wrong one? No, I had to reload, so probably Maybe, I don't know. Maybe, probably. What is this? Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, I don't know. Where am I? What am I doing? Alright, I need to force this to, I need to force this. So that should be pretty easy. Actually, that's all I need to do. Alright. Yay, debuggers! Okay. So load A, 3E, D9Y. And so this here should be checking which character is it. So we're going to get Terra, which should be 0. Right? Step into. It stays 0 because it's Terra, who is 0, compared to OC. And if it's branch equal, if it's go-go, then it does that thing. I don't really care about that. Compared to OB, branch of carry set. It registers carry is not set. Okay, good. And then increase. And then decrease. What do I have this in here for? Did I add that? I don't know if I added that. And if I did, why the heck is it even there? This could cause problems. This could be causing problems. Hey, Super Kristen Things. The zero flag is also set when you compare two things that are the same. Because it means zero difference. But under normal operation, if the accumulator is brought to zero, it sets the zero flag. Hence why branch if equal. In fact, there was one up here when it was comparing to OC. Now, of course, it wasn't equal, so it didn't have the flag set. Oh, right. But yeah. Alright. I don't know why this is here. I don't know why this is here. Why am I doing a shift to the left with A? Is that something I accidentally added? Oh, I remember. This was supposed to double the number because I've got two attacks for each person. So it starts with double and then adds one more if they're near fatal. Okay. I know why that's there now. Because so ASL calc utilitor. So hypothetically, if we have this in binary, of course that's one in hex, where hex will stick go to decimal. Okay, and so if I shift those, if I shift all the bits to the left, then what I'm gonna end up with is 10, which in decimal is 2. And watch, if I do that again, shift to the left again, it's 100, which is 4, okay? And this works for any number. So, hypothetically, if I have 11, or 11, which is 3, if I shift that to the left, it's 110, and that's 6, which is double. So that's what was going on there. All right, so that's fine. And then it pushes X because I need to fix that later. So that should be fine. And let me, I don't know. All right. Push X and then load A 355EY. Is that where I put my... What is that? Why is that a thing? What is this again? Is that the character? No, that's my near fatal status. That's what that is. Never mind. So yeah, no near fatal status. So now it's transferring A to X, which is still zero. Kind of unfortunate that this is Terra, because we're not watching any of the numbers map across, but that's fine. But we are still seeing what we expect to see. And now it's loading D touchscreen. Alright. So, why is that 8? Oh, is that a long? Okay, well there's a problem there. That's the problem there. Yay, debuggers! This was expecting 3 values. No, hold on. I put them in reverse order. Oh, I'm a dummy. I did not put these in Endian order. I did not put these in reverse order. And so it reversed it, and now it's trying to look up the 80 bank. The 80 bank. And that is not what we want. Let's look at that. So that's at C215FC. F. And C is somewhere around here. BFCOD680. Can you believe that? Okay, so it should be at C0D680. Your preferred bank. I know that's hex 80. What it looks like is that you have $80 in your bank account. And let's be honest, that's probably pretty generous. Okay. Yeah, pull X should put X back because we pushed it here. Okay, we transferred A to X because that was our value that we were using for the pool here. And then after that's done, we have the value we want. And then we pull X, which puts X back to where it was before we started this whole operation. Yeah, I'm pretty sure the problem was just that I screwed that up. All right, and I did save it. So... reload the game. Run. Bam. I think we're gonna get it. I think we're gonna get it this time. Alright. We're gonna get it. Oh, wait, I want my breakpoint. Hiya! Alright. Step over. I can probably just jump into a certain part, but that's fine. Alright, step over and OF. And what I'm going to do is edit the registers. Change that to a 0. I know. I keep doing that. Oh well. That should actually still set the 0 flag, right? Yeah. Alright. So now we're coming to here. Loads Terra. Compares to C. Branch feasible. Blah, 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 blah. Increase, decrease. Double it. Push X. Load the thing. Bit O2. Is that an issue? Hold on. Push X, but I'm immediately changing A. No, because I already did that part. Yeah, ignore me. Never mind. All right, so step into. No, wait. Transfer A to X is here. Obviously, I can't do this. This is a problem. This is a logical error. I think we're gonna get, yeah, I know, right? Guys, this is the last piece of cake. It's only 10:15. We're only halfway through. I'll eat half of it now. Oh no. The whole thing came off. No more cake. Well, this is it. We can't have any more problems. Because I am out of emotional support. I am out of emotional support. No more problems. Okay, well, this is a problem right here. By the way. I can't. I have to push X and transfer A to X right away. How did I even do that? Why would I even do that? That doesn't make sense. You and me both. You and me both. We're gonna get one, but I just found another error in the code. Okay. I think I might have Oreos somewhere, like the tiny little packets. So I have to find that. Increase X isn't doing anything. Oh! Actually, that answers my question. I'm smarter than I thought I was. Because we're not increasing, because our value is already in X, and we're just going to increase X. Okay, apparently I thought of this last time without even realizing it. Yeah. We're fine. At least we're fine here. I'm not sure we're okay up here. Okay, we're okay, and this is why. Because I push X, and that is my character offset doubled. And then we're loading A, so that's not an A anymore. And we check the bit, and then we branch of equal, and so that what we're increasing is X, and that's the thing that we wanted to increment. Oh, so this is wrong, though. So this actually needs... So we are still slightly wrong. Push X, this transfer A to X needs to go up here. Needs to go up here, and then we're okay. So this is in the wrong place, but then the rest of this is okay. All right? Are you following me? Because hypothetically, if we were working with a different character, you were going to basically see we pushed X, got rid of it, and then we transfer A to X. It needs to happen right away. So it needs to go to DA, straight to AA, and then the rest of this crap. Okay. All right, so where was this at? OA, DA, and then let's grab all this right here. I'll copy that, put AA in, and then paste insert, and we should be back in the money. Right there. You know what that means? Load game, desperation, run. And make sure my breakpoint's set. Oh, Terra. We'll get a desperation attack out of you yet. I think we're gonna get it this time. I said that last time. And the time before that. Missed my ATB bar. Alright, actually, where was the other thing? Oh, no. I need to get at least two step over. I need to get at least to here. And it looks like we're actually going to get it anyway, because this is already a zero. But 15D7. D7. Make that the new breakpoint. Step into, yep, 0, 0. So we already got And we already got our zero flag. So that this one would have actually worked out anyway. Alright. Which equal, which it will. Do that. Compare to C, blah, blah, blah. Increase A, decrease A. Shift. Push X, transfer A to X. This is all staying zero, but that's okay. That's okay. And then it loads that, and so it should see that. All right, so we've got the right address. Ah, I did it again. C0D680. Good, good, good. And F0. I think that's Mirager. I think that's Mirager. Puts X back in place, stores it in B6. Okay. Are you ready? Riot Blade, I mean. Mirager is Lux. Hey! Alright. I think we have done it. I think we have our main block of code debugged and working properly. I'm gonna keep doing testing with Tara, because she's the only one with boosted rates. Alright. Alright, so this first one's not gonna run. So we're gonna get back around to it again. 7F, not gonna work. We're gonna get back around to it again. 7B. This is still messed up. I don't know why this is here. Maybe because there was a carry already set. And so when I rotated, it brought it back in the other side. That's what happened. That's fine. That's not going to cause any problems. It's just sloppy. It's just sloppy. And because I can... Bing! Because I can, I'm going to... do that. Hiya! Yeah. Yeah. Shadow's gonna do it too. Shadow's gonna do it too. Shadow Fang! Yeah! Desperation attacks. Cheating! Yes! All right. Okay, well, that's actually our main block of code. Everything from here is an expansion. Everything from here is an expansion. So we've got it so that it picks a new ability when in critical. So what do you guys want to do with it next? Okay, we have... still have 37 minutes before the allotted stop time, which I've never stopped at before. Let's expand it. Let's do something else. We talked about editing the abilities. Now that is opening up probably another like 2 and 3 weeks worth of coding. We can also expand what we've got here for other increased chances, like status effects, and which we had talked about doing. And adding another bonus chance at a desperation attack for near fatal, which I guess falls under status effects. So I could set a status effect block. How does that sound? How does that sound? You guys want to put in a status effect block? We can go back to our flowchart, create more chances. Of course, if I do it this way, I do want to clean up my, I do want to clean up what I did before. How about half chance desperation does double damage? That would be in another part of code, which we can certainly do. But we're opening the door to much, much more stuff. We're opening the door to much, much more stuff. And editing more areas. Let's add let's add status effects first, like other things that would... Unsuccess, of corpse. Co-purse? Is that when you, like, share money? Oops, what did I just do? Alright. Let's add added chance based on status effects. And also, one thing I want to do is, I don't need this set carry. And what I'm going to do is when I'm doing over here in the subroutine is I'm going to flip-flop these, the set carry and the rotate left. I'm going to switch these. So that way it sets the carry and rolls it in right away. No, I am totally down with doing the damage stuff too. It'll just be next week. This is going. We can literally drag this out for probably another 3 weeks if we want to, based on other things that we want to change. And considering the idea is to release this as a patch, then I see that as having potential. So yeah. So I'm gonna switch the set carries with the rotate left. That way I don't end up with the extra set carry that when I'm shifting everything back to the right, that doesn't come back around to the other side and give me weird numbers over here. See how this is, it's 4-5 now because I'm in the overworld. So I need to fix that. And for that, I need to go to C0, whatever the heck it was. Why don't you show me here? I don't need any of this. That was for a different... Oh. What is all this? I don't need you. You're not in this part of the code. And I don't need that either. I need this. D640. Which means I'm going to D840. Okay. And I'm looking for my why didn't I copy those down? That's right. I know rotate left is gonna be have 2F3F in it. This 2E2F3F, that's the command right there. So 38 is the set carry, and that sounds right to me. So I'm gonna copy that. So 3-8, and I'm going to copy that, because I'm going to fix that everywhere else, too. And it should be in two places, right? There and there. Alright. 2-8-3-2-8-3-8. Bing. And then two more times down here. Yep, bing. And bing. And the last thing should be the return at the end. Yes. Okay. So that is properly set. Back in the main branch, I can get rid of this one here. I can just store zero and then stop. Where was this at? 2-1-5. Oh, excuse me. I'm going to use 7. CC. That. And that 3-8, I can knock it out and get rid of that. So, yay. And not process. Do not process. Alright, so that's gonna fix getting the extra bits out in the high byte that we were trying to avoid. And then what we're going to end up doing is just add another subroutine right here to do more stuff. All right. What status effects? Does anyone remember what status effects we decided on using? Spell. we decided on dark and poison, condemned, near fatal, although near fatal might have its own. You? Maybe? I don't have too many. There's only 8 bits, and you can already have up to 3, up to 4 maybe? Did I have it so you could, when it runs the code, this is the equipment slot, this is the you know, weapon and shield, or technically 2 weapons if you're Genji Glove, and then this is the relics. So there's a chance for having up to 4 of those bits. You know, is there a reason I can't just change this to an increase instead of using the bits and rotating? I mean, I like the whole, you know, checking the carry, but I can always just check if not equal. Morph, slow, poison, condemn, near fatal. Dark, poison, condemned. Morph, that gives it a reason, right? So maybe, maybe I just leave it at these 4, because if you can have up to 4 bits set with the with just your equipment, then I only have 4 more bits to work with. So, dark, poison, condemn, near fatal. Does that sound good? Or do you think we should drop poison or dark for more for whatever else? What do you guys think? Dark more slip. That's 6. So we need to at least drop. We can have a maximum of 4. I can always do near fatal as its own check. I mean, technically, I could do any of these as their own check. I could have it run this, and then check, and then run the other thing, and then go back and check it again. Which part makes sense? All of it. All of it. Yeah. I agree. They apply to every character. I just wanted to make Morph meaningful. But I guess it already is. On any non-capped character, Morph still actually deals a ton of stinking damage. Yeah, alright, so dark, poison, condemn, near fatal. And I only have 2 status bytes to load in order to check that. And I don't have to go out of my way to create additional checks for near fatal. Yeah, we're definitely keeping condemned. It's like the definition of being desperate. Alright, so let me find those 2 things. Honestly, I can put them here. There's no reason not to put them right here. I don't even need to add another subroutine. The only reason I was going to do that before is just to logically separate it, but there's not really a reason for that. So this is, wouldn't be equipment check, this would just be equipment slash status check function. And it's going to look just like this, with different those. This is looted relic things, right? Yeah. Yep. All right, RAM map. So now I need to put, not by attack. What is my current status, character statuses? What is my character's status? Where's the rest of their information? Because I'd imagine it's in the same general vicinity. 3B and 3C, so we're looking in... Not that. Threes. In the threes. Not block status. What is it? Relic effects, special weapon. Oh, here it is. Status bite 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Yeah, 1, 2, 3, and 4. No, wait, status to set and status to clear. What is the one... What is currently this? This, please? Yeah. The problem with checking this right now is that it's not... Oh, hold on. I know how we can check this. Where is... Imp. Imp is in status 1, and I can set that. So let's get in here, and we'll find out if we're right. Alright. I don't really care about that. Just show me the hex. Oh, it's over here. All right, and so I'm looking for 3EE4. Set range. No. Oh, 7E3EE4. 2-0. So that is bit 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Bit 5. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, we're in the right spot. Or at the very least, it appears we are in the right spot. Okay. And we're going to have to load it each time. I mean, technically I could probably work out something that did that slightly more efficiently, but it's not really worth it. All right, so 3EE4, that's what I want to load. 3EE4, so copy, paste, 3EE4, Y, and we're checking bit 0, and bit 3. Oh, that's going to be confusing the way I'm saying that. That's bit 01. Branch if equal, branch if it's 0. So branch if it's not set. Set carry. Roll. And then... 2 and 4 would be bit 3. All right. And now we'll do the same thing, only with 5. And do the same thing again with 5. And you're checking 1 and 2. Bit 1. and bit 02. So yeah, so loads that up, checks for blind, loads it again, checks for poison, loads it again. Could condemned be, like, be better as it's nearer to zero? I'm not entirely sure what you mean by that. But this is more or less cookie cutter from what we already did. Also, let me fix these. I don't already don't even remember what it was. D840. Yes, I do. Also, I'm running low on space here. I might have to change that to one higher. Actually, no. I'm going to change this down to one lower. Which means where's my stinking table? It's here, it needs to go down to 90. Right. COD690. Go to 217. See what I'm actually looking for. It's that thing that I changed over here. 90. I'm moving a little bit quick right now, but I think it's because the handful of people on know more or less what I'm talking about and what I'm doing. D40 back up here. Right. And really what I'm doing is I'm basically copying. That's bit, branch of equal, pass the thing, set carry, is that 4? Why is that 04? Am I paying attention? Did I do something silly? Branch of equal, 1, 2, it should be going down to here. Shouldn't be jumping down to here again. It should be only branch of equal 2. Oh, no, I'm sorry, because this has two other bytes in it. Yeah, I know what I'm talking about. I've done this before. So that is our template. And the 6B, which was our return. I need to do this 4 times. 1, 2, 3. Dang it. Gotta drop that down again. Oops. Drop that down again. I'll fix it. Right there. Copy. Yes. And paste. Okay. So what I just did was I dropped my table, the attack table, down to C0D6A0. D6A0. Go to 217A0. D840. And I copied this portion of the logic 4 times to account for all that. And then at the very end, I need 6B to return. Return to long. Okay. Alright, so now I just need to fix the bytes that I'm working with. Yes, okay. So we should be doing E43E, because endian order, I'm not forgetting this time. E, and the first one you're checking first bit, which is correct. Doing bit 01, yada 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 yada. B9, E43E. And the second time I'm checking for bit, I'm doing bit 4, yada 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 yada, B9, E53, bit 01, E53, bit 2. Finish and return. That should do it. That should being the keyword, should do it. Okay. All right. Let's do some things. I think we're rolling now. I should increase the monster hit points. Those guys are gonna run away. Alright, so I'm gonna poison Terra. And I'm going to blind Terra. Wait, what? Dagnabbit overpowered. I'm sitting here trying to harm my own characters, and they're like, oh crap, these people are crazy, I'm getting out of here. Now cast it on yourself. Yay! Aww. Okay, I might need to adjust the odds. Also, I need to find something that doesn't run away. Okay. Oh, Paladin Shield! Wouldn't you know it? I'm going to absorb everything. Alright, get rid of this. Or Diamond Shield. Because, why not? And relics. What did I set it on? Earrings. I think earrings was one of the things I set it on. I don't know if I have a poison rod. Probably. This is a downloaded save file. Do I have... Yes, I'm pretty sure I have a poison rod. There's the rods. Poison rod! Is there a dark spell in this game? I don't even remember. Can I blind my own character? Actually, to be fair, if I have everything, I could curse shield myself. That would totally do it. Oh, this makes curse shield overpowered. Hold on. Tell me there's a force shield. I need a cursed shield. Cursed shield is OP. I might have to hack this save so I can get another cursed shield. Okay. know what? Go ahead and save that. Okay. Alright, well, at the very least I can poison Terra. And then, why did the game just stop? Did it hit a breakpoint? I think it hit my breakpoint. Oh, it hit my breakpoint. Ah, what? Are you kidding me? Oh, wait, we talked about this. Ha. Yeah, I know. I thought about that right after I did that. Ouch. Alright, and do I have my breakpoint set? I do. I'm actually going to go back up here. Let's see how many chances we can get her. So store 0. 3F2F. Oh. 3F2F. Set range. Let's make sure we're back over here. And we're skipping that. So we're jumping into the equipment. Alright, here's our thing. Alright, so the first thing it's loading is the equipment. The Lumina totally counts. So we should get one right away. Let's check in the other. It's checking the shield slot. Nothing in there. Shouldn't set anything. Hold on. You know what? I think I did that wrong. Yeah, I think... What? I think I did that wrong. Branch equal. It's not 0, 0. I might have to check on that. But whatever. I'll come back to that. I do not want to muddle Gaul. That's asking for trouble. Alright, so now we're checking the relics. And earring definitely does it. So we're up to 7. The second one doesn't do anything. We're checking the status. You are poisoned. What? Maybe that bit command is actually calling for the actual bit, not a value. Because it just failed the one that is supposedly poison. Unless the statuses are out of battle statuses. 3EE4. And she's at 0-4. She's at 0-4. I must have the statuses wrong. And I'm going to stop loading my ROM so I don't accidentally do anything. Let's jump into unmodified. Which is also a terrible idea because I need it to be unmodified. 1, 2... Oh, poison is that one. I'm sorry. I was checking the wrong one. So we're still okay. So that failed properly. But this one, bit 04, branch of equal, and it should not do that. Okay, so that worked. And then these should both fail. So let's go back to my 3F2F. So we're up to 4 chances. We're up to 4 chances to roll. Actually 5, because it runs once before it even does it. So we've got 5 chances now. And then both of these should fail, and they do. Both of those fail, and they do. All right, so breakpoints. Let's load this one now. So 13. And what we're looking for here is we're looking for the randomly generated number to have a zero here. All right, so 2, 3, 4, 5. And this is the last chance, because as you can see, dang it, I still have a, carry that's popping up when I do that. I may have to add a clear carry somewhere to make sure that that doesn't happen. But anyway, we did get 5 chances there to roll for a desperation attack. And so with what turned out to be 3 pieces of equipment, although I'm pretty sure I have this wrong, because the second piece of equipment is some kind of shield, and I did not set anything up on the shields, right? Gave, so is it diamond shield, I think? Or crystal shield? I don't know, but it does not have that bit. Does not have that bit to even check. So yeah. Where's Illumina? Properties. That should have just been an empty. Should have been an empty byte. So I'm not sure what to make of that. But that's pretty minor. As you can see, we got 5 chances. And it should have only been 4, but that was because of the gear check, not because of the logic. So that's all running properly. So this actually failed, and she'll do a regular tech. But she did crit. So we'll take that. Oh, look, we're here again. I'm not sure what's doing this. I'm not sure what's causing that. Was it the Genji helmet? Was that the thing it was doing? No. I think we decided against that, because it's using a different, maybe you're right. Maybe you are right. Checking the helmet slot for a certain thing. Shield, 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 shield. Kenji helmet. Did I set a thing on here? I did not set a thing on here. I did not set a thing on here. But we had left room for 2 different things, like one relic and one, that was under relic effects. Let's go back and look. Hold on. Let's find out what we're looking at here. This should be the first hand, and this should be the second hand. And this is relic effects loaded. So hypothetically, you could set that in the armor too, I think, because it has the possibility of having these relic effects on them. And so we have 2 possible chances, which, by the way, that should not work, I don't think. Well, maybe, no, it will. It doesn't change the value of A, it's just checking it. So actually, that would work. In fact, I probably don't need to have the second load in here, but whatever. We're just trying to make it work. Yeah, as long as she has MP, she'll crit, right? I think that's what it is. So that. I'll check this just in case. I'll check this just in case. I think this is the second hand, but maybe you're right. Maybe that is the armor slot. 3BA4 and 3BA5. 3B. Yeah, left hand weapon. Right hand weapon, left hand weapon. But when it loads the relic effects, that can actually be set for armor also. I'm not sure why it's working when 3BA5 is loaded. I'm not sure why that has a value in it at all. As best as I can tell, 3BA4 for Terra. Oh yeah, she's poisoned. Should be zero. It is. Breakpoints, set you, and attack. Alright, store zero, blah, 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 blah. Alright, so load A, 3BA4, and we should get A3, and we do. Bit one is set, so it's going to set the zero flag, so... I mean, it does not set the zero flag. Why is this always confusing me? All right, whatever. The first one, and then 3BA5 should load 00. And it does. And so that should fail. Oh, okay, well, it worked this time. Never mind. This whole time we were chasing our tails, there was actually no problem at all. I was looking at that 3, but that 3 is actually only 2 chances. That's 1 and 1. I was looking at that and thinking it was 3. But that's obviously wrong. Because we're talking about hex and binary, not decimal. Alright, thanks, Locke. Actually, I'm gonna cut it here, too, because it looks like we have this working. So she got all of her chances. Everyone should get at least one chance. This is the last thing I'm going to do. So he got his one chance. It's the last thing I'm going to do. Finish checking this up, and then next week we'll start working on modifications for the abilities. Because why not? Or a damage multiplier or something. We'll figure out what we want to do. So we want this to be for hackers, then we want them to be able to change values. And so, changing specific things. Terra has 1 HP. Oh, that means she's near fatal. No! Poison killed her. I need more cake. Yeah, I get it. Stupid that. I'm so sorry, Terra. I need to poison her again, though. I will poison her again. We succeeded. This is a group effort. Let's be fair, I would not be doing this if I didn't have people watching me do it, because I am not that motivated to do anything. I just had Realm do that. That was a bad move. Please don't kill her. Yep. What made me think having Realm do a magic attack on one of my characters was a good idea? That's right. Sign should be alright. 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 Let's see. how many chances we get. 3F, 2F. So we've got five chances, I guess, according to that, which is what we worked out. And that's, so we're running the first one, fail, second one, fail, third one, fail, fourth one, fail, fifth one, fail. But what we should be working with, hypothetically, is a 1 in 16 chance. So, it's 1 divided by, clear. We want 15 divided by 16 chance that it won't happen. I'm sorry, scientific. 15 divided by 16 raised to, we're getting 5 shots at it. So right now we're working with almost a 30% chance to use a desperation. So it shouldn't take that long. Especially if I add... I'm going to save my state. I'm going to do a save state. Where is the thing? I lost it. Isn't it like control or alt or something? Dagnabbit. What is it? Shift F1? Man, I don't want to do the wrong thing. I don't want to die. Potions! Alright, come on, get in a fight. Hiya! T7, alright, so we failed. Failed. So with our almost 30%... You know, we can get a max of 3. We could have added one more. We could have added one more conditional. Oh, look, we passed. We passed. You see it? You see the 0? Riot Blade! Yeah. Alright, well, we've made desperation attacks happen more often. I'll probably clean this up. I think we've covered this. I think we've covered the main portion of our logic. So I'll probably tweak it a small amount to button it up. I might change the rate a little bit. I don't know how much. But yeah, I might change the rate a little bit, just to see. And then next week we'll start working on our whatever other modifications. I'll open up something on the forum soon, and we'll talk about what we want to do next week, whether we want to move on to another topic, or what we might want to do to flesh out this particular patch. But, yeah, we're getting somewhere. This is actual progress, not the kind of progress where you find all the things that you have to figure out what's wrong with it, because that happens a lot. That's where we ended up last time, 2 weeks ago, and that was a little disconcerting. But that's what hacking is. Hacking is a lot of trial and error. So, that's it. Thanks you guys for coming out, and happy hacking. We will see you next time.